Election Commissioner Ashok Lavasa has become a sudden favorite of all the probe agencies in the country, including Income Tax and Enforcement Directorate, as many of his five family members are currently facing a probe. To just refresh your memory as to who is Ashok Lavasa is the election commissioner, the only election commissioner who stood his grounds and dissented on the clean sheet that was given to Prime Minister Modi and Amit Shah in May this year for violating the Model Code of Conduct in their various election speeches that were made. Since then, he and his family have been facing probe of various agencies. Cut the chase to September this year, Noble Lavasa, wife of Ashok Lavasa, is suddenly asked to furnish details of her income tax record. The income tax officials alleged that she did not declare her income and asset in accordance with the law of the land. Not just that, their son Abir Lavasa is also facing the probe of Enforcement Directorate. Enforcement Directorate is currently looking into a company that is held by Abir Lavasa and whether that company violated the FEMA regulations in the country. There was a transaction that was made, the company received about 7.5 crore, it raised 7.5 crore and ED is looking into whether the FEMA regulations were complied with. Ashok Lavasa himself is facing a probe. We are given to understand that Power Ministry has written to as many as 11 PSUs asking them to furnish any details of whether Ashok Lavasa exercised any undue influence when he was the Power Secretary between 2009 and 2013. So nearly entire Lavasa family, five members of Lavasa family are currently facing probe. So why exactly is this happening? When you look at it from a bird's eye view, it's a clear case of a dissenter who's currently being charged, who's currently being punished by the government. He was the only man who stood his grounds. He was the only man who said that your politicians should be made accountable to the public. He wanted his dissent note to be a part of the official record. Remember, one of the violations that was noted and that later got a clean sheet was when Prime Minister was talking to people in Latur and he asked the first-time voters to vote in the name of Pulwama martyrs. A defense issue was used to garner votes. Many more such incidents, including all five of them, got a clean sheet from the Election Commission. And Ashok Lavasa said, no, they should not. Now, if you look at the seniority that he enjoys, and that's perhaps the second reason why he's facing what he's facing, he is most likely to be the chief election commissioner of the country. And it will be then very difficult to remove him. To remove a chief election commissioner, it requires 2/3 majority of both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. And an impeachment has never happened. A CC impeachment has never happened in the history of this country. So here's a man who basically stood his grounds in front of a major political party. He's all set to be the next chief election commissioner and is suddenly facing probe of various government agencies. A case that appears to be a classic case of killing the dissenter and killing the dissent. Thanks for watching.